In this demonstration, we're going to take a look at the test client extension that is available as a sample from the Retail SDK. So I have Visual Studio open and I'm running as an admin. I'm going to go to File, Open, and I'm going to select Project and Solution. So from the K drive, I'm going to navigate to the Retail SDK. Then go ahead and select Sample Extensions. I'm then going to select Retail Server, and here we can see different extensions that are available, and we'll actually take a look at each one of these in the next demonstrations. But to start, we're going to take a look at the Test Client extension. So I'll go ahead and double click this. We can actually go through here and view some of the data that is included within this Retail SDK. We can view properties if there are any, but here we can see our project. And then this is important to note as well, we can look at the type here. So if we look over here on the very right hand side, we can see this is a Visual Studio C Sharp file. Here we can see that this is a Visual Studio solution. So we can go ahead and I'm going to open up the solution. And we can see the different projects that are included within this Retail SDK solution. Here we can see and note all of the C# files that we have here, and we can see the classes that are included in each one of those. So let's just take a look at one of these. Let's take a look at the Commerce Entity class here. So what I can do is drop this down. I can open up this class if I wanted to view the code for this. I can also see the different methods as well as events. So here we can see we have an event handler. Here we can also see the object here as well, so we have the property of changed event args, so we can see some further information over here on the right hand side in the Solution Explorer. Let's just go ahead and take a look at some of the classes that are included with this commerce entity here. And what I can actually do, I can look at classes a couple of different ways. I can view that within the code editor here, and I can also, if I click over on the right, see different methods as well. But I'll go ahead and right-click on Commerce Entity, and I can view the class diagram. So here we can see our Commerce Entity or iCommerce Entity class here. We can see all of our methods. So included in this class, we have the clear changed properties, which will clear your changed properties. We also have a clone method, which will clone an entity. We also have the commerce entity method, which will initialize a new instance of the specific class here. And we can see the property for a changed event handler. You can see here we can add another method, and then down below we can see additional properties and events. So here we have a property changed event where this will occur when a property value changes. And if we wanted to see that event, we can go ahead and open that if we wanted to. I'm going to open that from the Solution Explorer. And here we can see our public event type property changed event handler for a property changed. We can see here our summary. So this gets or sets a value indicating whether this instance is notification disabled. So if this instance is notification disabled, otherwise it'll be false. So we can see our true and false here. I'll go ahead and collapse our commerce entity here. We can continue on looking at the different C# components of this as well. So maybe we'll take a look at the manager factory class as well. So I can right click on this, and I'll go ahead and view the class diagram for manager factory. So here you can see I have the other class that we had open before. I'm going to select the manager factory class, and here we can see our methods. So we have a create method, the manager factory method. This will initialize static members of this specific class here. As before, we can take a look at each of these and see a summary of them. We can also hide them over on the right hand side. Again, we can see our different fields and events. So another important thing to note about these SDK extension samples is if I scroll all the way down on my Solution Explorer, I'll be able to view all of the DLLs that support this specific operation. So here we can see all of the DLLs within this solution. Now let's take a look at the cross-loyalty SDK sample that is available for Retail Server. So I'm just going to go ahead and close the solution. So I'll go to File, and we'll close this solution. And I don't need to save anything because I didn't change it. And I'm just going to go back to File, Open, Project and Solution. And I'm just going to go back here. This is where we were before, so Sample Extensions, Retail Server. Let's now go ahead and take a look at the cross-loyalty sample. And I'll just go ahead and open up this C# project file. So here we can see over on the right-hand side our C# project file, and we can see our properties references, and then we can see each part of this here. So we can see here that we have the customized EDM model factory, the EDM model extender, global suppressions, as well as my customer's controller. So we'll just go ahead and view the class diagram for all of this. So if I right-click on this project, I can go to View, and we'll select View Class Diagram. So we can kind of pick this apart and just look at the different methods that are available and if we have any methods that come with this sample. So we have three different classes here. So we have the customized EDM model factory. We can see here we have the build actions method. If we scroll down, we can see that's the only method within this class. We'll look at this next one. We have the extend model, and then we also have the get cross-loyalty card discount action method here. So the action to get the cross-loyalty card discount. Again, I can drop this method down and take a look at some parameters, the type, as well as some additional summary information as well. And we can actually add parameters and methods as the other samples that we just saw here as well. So lastly, let's take a look at the store hours sample that comes available for Retail Server as well. So I'm just going to do a File and Open. And I'm going to go ahead and select the store hours sample. We'll just go ahead and open up this C# project, and we don't need to save anything from this last one. So here we have the store hours sample, and we'll just go ahead and take a look at the class diagram for this as well and see what comes available for us. So here we have the customized EDM model factory with the build actions and build entity sets methods of type void. We can see here that these build the entity sets. Again, we can drop these down and view the parameters. We also have the EDM model extender, which extends the EDM model, and the store hours controller. So this gets store days by store. This gets the store hours for any given store. And we also have some properties for this in a string type, which we can hover over this, or we can expand this to kind of see some more details about it. But we can use the controller name used to load the extended controller.